Hi and welcome to this fourth video of the module, in which we will talk about vocabularies for representing geographical information. Geographical information is one of the most common type of data that we can find available, which will allow us to draw information about resources in a map. For example, if you have information about touristic places or places of interest, we can represent them on a map using points. And precisely for that, for representing the information about points, we have vocabularies such as, for example, WGS84, in which we have the concept of a point, which has a property for the latitude and for the longitude. So as we see here, a point in this vocabulary is just a concept of an instance of the point class, which a number for the latitude and a number for the longitude. But what happens if we want to represent more complex information rather than just points, for example, lines or polygons? For that, there is an extension in which we have the geo point from the WGS84 vocabulary and other classes such as, for example, curve or polygon that can be understood as, in the case of a curve, a collection of two or more points. And in the case of a polygon, three or more points. Here we see an example of an instantiation of deep vocabulary in which we have an individual that is of type curve that it's composed by a set of points. We have two points here. These two elements are geopoints, which the longitude and latitude information. And in this case, we have the order for them. So this is the first element, and this is the second one. So we will have, in, for example, in our map, when we're using this, a curve for representing a line from this first point to this second point. As we introduced before, geographical information is really common, and there are a lot of tools that will allow us automatically, by using this type of vocabularies, such as WGS84, to automatically retrieve the information, the geographical information from our dataset, and put it on a map.